Welcome to St. Francis. My name is Mary, and I'm a nurse on the maternity unit. Let me be one of the first people here to congratulate you on your growing family. It is a very exciting time, but you may also be feeling a bit of anxiety in regard to the birth of your baby. It is my hope that by taking you on a tour of the maternity units here at St. Francis, showing you the rooms and equipment, we may alleviate those fears. Upon arrival to St. Francis, you will want to locate the blue elevators, which are located on the first floor in the main entrance. These will take you up to the maternity units, which are located on the fourth floor. There's no need to stop at the admissions office when you come in to labor. We will complete the admission process on the labor and delivery unit. Our maternity units, labor and delivery, NICU, and postpartum are all locked units for your safety. You can access any of these units by using the telephone located on the walls by the doors of the units. There's no need to dial anything, just pick up the receiver, and when the unit secretary answers, please give the first and last name of the laboring patient. Our labor and delivery unit consists of 14 rooms. All rooms are private, and they each have their own attached three-piece bathroom, which includes a toilet, shower, and sink. All rooms have their own thermostat and television, and the entire hospital is equipped with free Wi-Fi. Make the rooms your own comfortable haven. Feel free to adjust the temperature and lighting to your desire. Bring in your preferred music, flameless candles, battery-operated diffusers, massagers, and other comfort items. Your nurse can provide a birthing ball, birthing peanut, squat bar, or mirror upon your request. Your room will also have two rocking chairs and a bed for our laboring patient, which can be configured to accommodate many different laboring positions. For your support person, each room comes equipped with a single pull-out sleeper. You may also bring a camera to take pictures. Videotaping is allowed in the labor rooms, but videotaping of the birth or any medical procedure is not allowed. When your baby is born, we will place your infant on your chest, and barring medical complications, we will wait a full 60 seconds before clamping and cutting the umbilical cord. A security sensor will be placed on the umbilical clamp, and two identification bracelets will be placed on your baby's wrist and ankle. An identical band will be placed on the new mother's wrist, and a fourth band will be placed on the wrist of the support person of our new mother's choice. Please note that infants must be with a person that has a matching identification bracelet at all times. Regardless of the method of your birth, you can expect to remain on the labor and delivery unit for at least 2 hours. Once it is determined that you and your baby are stable, you will transfer as a family to the postpartum unit where you will complete your stay. If you deliver vaginally, you can expect to stay 2 nights from the time of birth. And if you deliver via a C-section, you will be with us for 3 nights from birth. Each night ends at midnight. If you have other children at home and would like to discuss alternate discharge options, please speak to your healthcare provider. Our postpartum unit consists of 29 private rooms. All rooms have their own attached three-piece bathroom, which includes a toilet, shower, and sink, as well as their own thermostat and television. Your room will also have one rocking chair and a bed for our new parent. We are able to accommodate one support person overnight as each room comes equipped with a single pull-out sleeper. Your new baby will be provided with their very own bassinet for sleeping. We will have diapers, wipes, t-shirts, swaddle blankets, hats, and burp cloths for your new baby, so all you will need to bring for your baby is an outfit to go home in and a car seat. Please be sure to have your car seat installed and checked for safety before your arrival to the hospital. For our new mothers, we will provide all your current medications as well as any new medications prescribed by your obstetrician. Comfort items such as hot packs, cold packs, lanolin, hospital gowns, underpants, menstrual pads, and basic toiletries, which include deodorant, bar soap, shampoo, toothbrush, toothpaste, and mouthwash, will be available. So all you will need to bring is an outfit to go home in. There is a kitchenette area available on the unit, complete with a fridge and microwave. Our new mothers are served meals from the cafeteria on an on-demand basis between the hours of 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. Food is available at Panera Bread 24/7 on an in-person, pay-per-item basis. The nurses' station also has a list of local restaurants that will deliver directly to St. Francis's main lobby. St. Francis has a staff of 5 lactation consultants that are here 7 days a week, and there are hospital-grade pumps available for use when needed. Need a pump to go home with? No problem. We have a variety of pumps for you to choose from that are covered by most insurance plans and are available for you to take with you upon discharge. We also have hospital-grade loaner pumps available for our NICU families. Professional photographers are also available 7 days a week to capture those first moments with your new babies. Upon arrival to the postpartum unit, you can expect to be greeted by your family nurse and a nursing assistant who will assess you and your baby and acclimate you to the unit. Your new baby will receive the first of their medications, erythromycin antibiotic ointment, vitamin K injection, and hepatitis B vaccine at this time. If you have had a vaginal birth, you can expect to be assessed every 4 hours for the first 12 hours and then every 8 hours after that. If you delivered via C-section, you will be assessed every 4 hours for the first 24 hours and then every 8 hours for the remainder of your stay. Infants are assessed every 8 hours. For patients with medical complications, more frequent assessments may be necessary. Every morning, you can expect your obstetrician and/or an OB resident to assess you, and either your chosen pediatrician or one of St. Francis's neonatologists will assess your infant. When your infant is 28 hours old, your nurse will assess your infant for jaundice, congenital heart defects, congenital hearing loss, and a selection of genetic diseases. Housed on the maternity unit, St. Francis has a level 3 NICU. Our NICU consists of 4 pods that house 7 beds apiece in order to decrease simulation to the infant and increase privacy for families. We have board-certified neonatologists on staff, as well as multiple mid-level providers such as nurse practitioners and physician assistants who are here to monitor the infants 24/7. We hope you have enjoyed this tour of the St. Francis Maternity Units. For more information about labor and delivery, postpartum care, newborn care, and breastfeeding, please click on the purple link located under this video. Thank you and congratulations.